We no rise and boast. Yeah, we give thanks like we need it the most.
Hey loves, welcome back to my channel. My name is Adanna, and if it's your first time stopping by,
hello
who? Hello boo. So today's video, y'all, I'm going to take you all through how I achieve this. Look at this hairstyle, just come through this easy crochet braid. Yes lord, the cornrows is not your ministry, this hairstyle will be your calling. Because guess what, this hairstyle has no cornrows, it's so easy, and there is no leave out, absolutely no leave out at all. So if you want to see how we achieve this natural looking crochet braid from head to toe, then please keep on watching, and without further ado, let's get started.
So y'all, starting off on freshly washed, lusciously juicy natural hair, I'm just going to go right now to do like a quick moisturizing, because you know this is the only part that's remaining for my wash day routine to be complete. And I'm using the Curls Blueberry Bliss Leave-In Conditioner, and then to seal in all of that moisture, I'm currently using my Jamaican Black Castor Oil. For the foundation of this crochet braid, y'all, like I said, there is no cornrows, absolutely no cornrows. So for this foundation, we're just going to go ahead right now to do like individual plaits. If you feel more comfortable doing individual twists, feel free to go ahead to do some individual twists. You know, just play around with whatever works for you. The foundation of this hairstyle does not have to be perfect at all. The patterns, it doesn't have to strike. The pattern can just be going as the spirit leads. It does not have to be perfect, because at the end of the day, it's going to be covered anyway. So we just need a base, all right? For this front part right here, I just wanted to show you all something to make this hairstyle look flawless and to keep your braids flat. You don't want to do your regular three-stranded braid where you're that. You don't want to do that. Nope. That's going to give you like a knot. So you want to make sure that this three-stranded braids that you're doing for your crochet base is as flat as possible, and it looks knotless. Okay, so basically we're going to be doing the reverse braided method. So basically braiding from, you know, from as if you're braiding from the back technically, so the other way around. I hope this makes sense, but you don't want to, you know, create that knot at the roots of your braids, just so your crochet hairstyle looks flat and everything just stays flat. So if your hair is also a lot thicker than mine, you want to make sure that you're working in small sections. So you're doing like smaller plaits. But if your hair is less thicker than mine, of course, you could go ahead to even increase the size of your plaits. But just try to make sure that the plaits at the foundation, that's the root of your hair right here, is as flat as possible. So here is our foundation of this crochet braid that we're going to be using to make this magic happen right now. We're going to be using a weaving cap. Yo, I think I had this weaving cap from a random wig I've had in the past. But yeah, this is the weaving cap. You can find this on Amazon, at your local beauty supply store, anywhere at all. I'm just going to go ahead right now to put on this weaving net cap. Tie the knot, is it knot? The loop, the net, the remnants of the net right there at the back. Tie that just so the back is sealed and everything is secure, and there is no like huge chunky hole that my hands could pass through. And then one thing to make sure that you're doing is that when you put on this weaving net, push it back a little bit. You don't want it to be onto your forehead, especially if you're intending to create a side part or a middle part. Also make sure that you have your side patterns from your entire base of your crochet braid foundation. And that quick thing I forgot to do was to cut out that excess net at the back. I was supposed to cut that out, I don't know how I forgot. Thankfully it didn't really affect the entire hair, it wasn't showing at all, but please cut it out. Don't forget, okay? So now that all that is set and this foundation is looking good and ready for installation, we're moving on right now to the entire crochet process. The hair extension I'm using in this video is the Outre Twisted Up Waterwave Afro Twist, and shout out to Outre for partnering up with us today. This is the color 1B, and it's also in 22 inches. The beautiful part about this extension, y'all, is the fact that it's pre-fluffed and it's pre-separated. You all know, like the regular water wave hair, most of them are already, they're not separated at all. They're not separated, so they are more prone to tangling compared to this one. It's less prone to tangles, because majority of the tangles that results from curly hair is during the entire separating process, but this one has been separated for us. And the other beautiful part about this extension is the fact that it blends even more with our natural hair, as it has an afro textured fail. To install this entire hair to our hair, let's go ahead right now to cut this hair extension into two equal halves because I wanted it to be like a bob length. I didn't want it to be too long, so I wanted to, you know, just the short look. And then I'll be grabbing each strand of this hair extension from this bundle right here, and I'll be splitting that into four. So four chunk of hair extension is what we're going to make out of this entire bundle of hair, and each of those strands from the four of them is what we're going to crochet onto our natural hair as well as onto the net. So grabbing your crochet hook right now, we're just going to go ahead to pass this crochet hook through our natural hair as well as through your net. The amazing part about using this hair net method is the fact that it also creates more base for you. So if your natural hair is quite fine, you know, fine density natural hair, this is even going to give you more holes and more base for you to crochet effortlessly without even having to go through your natural hair if you do not want to. The other amazing part about this net method is the fact that it's less tension. There's less tension on your natural hair because guess what? We have no cornrows. We have no cornrows, so your base is effortlessly tension-free. You're literally as free as a bird with this entire foundation for your crochet. That's the amazing part about this entire net method. So moving on to the entire crochet process right now, like I said, we're going to go ahead to grab our crochet hook, pass this through our natural hair and pass this through the net. Like I previously mentioned, you do not have to pass this through your natural hair if you do not want to, but passing the hook through your natural hair as well as through the net gives the net extra security while staying in place with your natural hair, such that the net is not going to move. It's just going to be there. It's going to sit right and good, no shaking. Okay, taking you all through the entire step by step of how to knot this hair to your head, we're going to go ahead right now to grab your crochet hook, grab the hair extension, pass it through just like so, grab one side of this hair extension and loop that in there twice. Okay, and that's basically how I created the knot for this entire crochet method. So repeating this method again, we're going to go ahead right now to pass our crochet hook, grab our hair extension, and I grab one side of this hair strand, put it into the loop and make a knot right there. This also gives it that illusion of knotless look without having to see the knot, especially when you get to the front. This method, this technique is very important. Okay,
in these streets I'm walking on air, in these streets I don't have a care, it's sweet sweet the winds in my hair.
So grabbing this crochet hook, passing this through your natural hair as well as through the net, grabbing this hair extension, then taking the side, the one strand or the side of your hair that's going to be covered, we're going to grab that, pass this hair using your crochet hook through the loop right there, make one extra knot. Okay, just one right there, just like so, put the knot through and then pull it. So the other strand, that's the other strand on your right, that's the one you guys can see right now on my right, is going to conceal the knots that we just created on the left. Do you get the gist right now? Exactly. So passing your crochet hook right there again, okay, taking the loop of your hair extension, grabbing the side that you want to cover, that's the left side of ours right now, looping that right there twice, and then the right side of this extension is going to cover and conceal the knots that we just made on the left. So whichever direction that you're going towards, make sure that you're concealing the knots of this hair extension using the hair extension itself and creating a knot on the opposite side of this hair extension, just like so. Okay, so we're creating the knot right here on this side. Creating the knot, that's the first one, and then we're going to now do the second one, just like so. There you go, and then pull, create a knot, and the other side covers it. Perfecto, perfecto, perfecto. And because we are going for a side parting, we made sure that we had the side parting during the entire natural hair braid for our base. We made sure that we kept our side parting, and also we also made sure that we pushed this weaving cap backwards just so the weaving cap doesn't come all the way forward to your forehead. And this is basically how we installed this head of hair. I ended up using 1.5 pack of this hair extension, and this entire installation process took 2 hours because I had to take my time to go individually. Right now, we're just going ahead to cut and shape it up, this entire crochet hair. Shape it up to your face. If your face is like strawberry, give yourself some strawberry look. If your face is like potatoes, give yourself some potato look. We're going to go right now to shape it up, this entire hair, for it to suit our facial structure. And then right now I'm going to go ahead to, you know, make sure that these edges are a little bit more significant, and I'll be using my Style Factor Edge Booster pomade. But y'all, this pomade, like I always tell you guys, turns white on my edges, so I always have to go over top of it using the Style Factor Edge Booster gel just to combat all of that whitish residue. All right, just, you know, swoop the edges a little bit, and then to effortlessly just take this front to the next level, just one more step. Grab your eyebrow razor or any razor of your choice, or like a teaser. Is it teaser or taser? I don't know what it's called, but try grab something that has razor and kind of like ruffle. Like, I don't really know if I'm explaining this properly, but I don't know if you guys will get what I'm trying to say. But find wherever you see, or wherever you think you're still seeing any knots at all, just go. You will get some hair that falls out, but this is going to give this crochet right here a very natural look. It will literally look like you're wearing a lace frontal weave. But that's how I achieve this entire flawless illusion knotless crochet install. A shout out to Beauty Can Braid, if I forget, Beauty Can Braid, for inspiring this. It's fine. Wait, well, English today is difficult though. For inspiring this entire technique, okay? And that brings us to the very end of this video. I hope you all enjoyed it. Thumbs up if you did, comment, share, subscribe. Yo, today's beauty was on a different level. But I hope you enjoyed this video. Thumbs up if you did, comment. Let me know down below in the comment section if you've been rocking this hairstyle, if you've also tried this method of crochet braids, okay? And I can't wait to read your comments as always. And yeah, I'll see you on my next one. Have a lovely rest of your weekend. Bye! If you leave me, I will die. I suck. You are like the oxygen I need to survive. I'll be